what's her name? February 29th?
Oh my god, yeah!
I know, this day literally only comes once every 4 years.
That's true. Some of our teachers were just teenagers when this day last happened.
And the Summer Olympics happens in years with the February 29th.
That's right as well. There's a presidential election in years that have a February 29th.
I'm sure that someone here is celebrating their fourth birthday today. And turning 16 too. Bro, that's crazy. And happy birthday.
Hey, speaking of birthdays, did you know that tomorrow is the birthday of the United States?
I thought the country's birthday was the 4th of July.
Well, actually, Congress was first called into session on March 1st, 1781, under the Articles of Confederation. They also elected its first president.
George Washington!
No. A lot of people think that George Washington was the first, but actually the first president of the United States was a guy from Maryland named John Hanson.
Oh!
Washington didn't get elected as our president until 1789 under our current constitution.
Well, that's pretty cool. I had no idea. And also, happy leap day, everyone! And happy birthday to the United States tomorrow. Kind of.
Good morning, Topeka High. My name's Susie.
And I'm Anna, and this is your THS Morning Report.
On the run, there's life for living. But the people there, they just don't care. Living their life like a millionaire down on the border.
The THS Morning Report presents this film to bring awareness of dubious dab disorder, a disorder with an ever-growing population of victims. Let's allow this brave victim to introduce herself.
My name is Courtland, and I got diagnosed with dab disease 10 minutes ago. I don't know what else to say. Take it seriously.
In this clip, you can see these two victims struggling to fight the symptoms, but in the end, the disorder triumphs. Next, you can see this victim not only dab, but an uncommon side effect occurs where she hits a little jig, commonly known as the gritty. You can see Cortland enthusiastically come in to comfort her, as she too knows the struggle of this disorder. Unfortunately, not even the administrators are safe. As you can see in these clips, Jimenez is too affected, as well as Hayes. Can we get a replay, Rick? As you can see, he too is fighting, but even after he fails, he keeps smiling as he has gotten used to this life. Must be exhausting. In this clip, you can see the disorder strike this victim not once, but twice. Next, you can see this distressed old man trying to make sense of this situation. His life has spiraled out of control since his diagnosis, and he has become paranoid, so take caution when approaching. When will help come for these victims? Research is being done to find a cure to this life-altering condition, yet with slow progress due to lack of funding and awareness. With just a donation of $2, you can help bring solace into the lives of these unfortunate souls. In return, you will get this photo of Cortland trying to find positives in a life with this disorder.
SRO is nearly here. In case you don't know, it's like a talent show where Trojans of all stripes can strut their stuff.
There are singers, comedy acts, and musical acts. Shows are tomorrow and Saturday at 7 p.m. in the auditorium.
10th, 11th, and 12th graders can sign up for Build My Future on April 9th. Build My Future is an opportunity to spend the day in the construction industry. Industries available to visit with include carpentry,
heavy equipment,
welding,
concrete and asphalt,
electrical,
and many more. You'll leave at 8:30 and return around 11:30 that day. Sign up with the link posted in your grade level Google Classroom. And now, it's time to throw to lunch.
Ow!
It's 2024, you know what that means, it's leap year! Yay.
It's a leap year? Give me some stuff. What's for lunch?
Country fried steak, boneless buffalo wings with roll, veggie burger with fries, spicy chicken sandwich, green beans.
Yes, I love beans. Thank you.
The DMV will be at Topeka High April 22nd and 23rd. Students can sign up for an appointment to get their learner's permit, license, or state ID.
Paper tests will be offered for those who need them. Sign up through this QR code or visit room 204 for more information.
There will be a Native American Club meeting on Tuesday, March 5th in room 230, Mr. Smith's room. It will be at 3:15 p.m. You do not need to be Native American to join this club. You only need to have interest in Native American culture and history.
Now time for upcoming events. Today there is State Bowling at North Rock Lanes in Wichita,
International Foods Day in the World Language Hall,
and a parent softball meeting in the North Gym.
And don't forget to look for those link frogs today.
Get you a nice little present.
And that's all we have for you today, Topeka High.